נמצאת איתנו היום כאן קארן סקוג, העורכת של המהדורה הדיגיטלית של ניו יורק טיימס, אחד העיתונים הגדולים והידועים בעולם. העיתון וקארן צריכים להתמודד עם האתגרים החדשים שהעידן הזה מציב בפני העיתונות. Hi Karen, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
Can you tell us a little bit about your job in the New York Times?
Sure, I am the day editor for the website of the Times. I get in at about 6 a.m. every day and I start looking around at coverage around the world to see what the New York Times should focus on for the day and what angles are going to be best for us to cover any breaking stories or any ongoing news for the day. I lead our 10 a.m. morning news meeting where editors pitch their stories for the day, the best of their enterprise and the best of their news, and we make decisions about what will be on the website during the day, plot out our coverage, what will lead the site, some of the best photos for the website, some of the best graphics and videos, and we take it from there.
How do you choose actually the material and what priority to give speed over accuracy and depth or the other way around?
Depth is definitely our main concern, our main business. I think the Times readers come to our website expecting context in stories, expecting deep reporting, and we favor a lot of enterprise. I think our readers favor enterprise as well. We tend to leave some of the more pedestrian news stories of the day to the wires or, you know, things that not to send our reporters out to try to cover sort of basic things, but we also do mobilize them for breaking news. If there's a big breaking story, we're realizing that our readers are coming to us more during breaking news events than they have in the past too, so we do give some priority to that. But I try to give a good mix and think about the mix during the day of enterprise stories and good news stories. Mm-hmm. We also try to put a lot of Washington news up during the day. Mm-hmm. You know, we look at what the times that our readers are visiting us the most, and we think that Congress is going on in the afternoon and our readers sort of want to know what they're up to, so we mm-hmm. tend to give that priority as well.
What was the biggest challenge that New York Times faced in recent years?
I think integrating the print and digital newsrooms has been a mm-hmm. very big challenge at the Times, and we're still continuing on that path. Mm-hmm. But to go from a paper that's more than 160 years old to a website, taking the values and the journalistic standards onto that site and keeping them as high as we have in the print has definitely been our biggest challenge.
Mm-hmm. What would be your vision or even advice for other media outlets in this day and age of digital consumer websites taking over and application taking over?
This has been a challenge for the Times as well to try to figure out sort of what the key is for the future. We have had great success with our paywall. We have over 700,000 digital subscribers right now, which is up about, I think, 13% over last year. Mm-hmm. We continue to get subscribers there. That's not going to be enough. We have other products that we're trying to put out, including another news product that would be a lower subscription rate and might focus a little bit more on breaking news mm-hmm. and try to target younger readers as well, which we all are trying to attract. We're trying to put more efforts into our mobile site as well, knowing that younger readers find us through mobile more than any other platform. We're expanding our International Herald Tribune to be the International New York Times mm-hmm. and hoping to attract more global readers that way. I think that we are trying all of these different things, but we're also keeping in mind that our core values really need to stay the same, and we're not going to prioritize fast over facts. We really need to sort of remember who we are and try not to pay attention to other media outlets who might be reporting things quicker but maybe not as accurately. We think Times readers come to the Times website because they want to know the best, most accurate information, and that's our brand.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. אני נראה לי שבעוד 130 שנה עדיין יהיה ניו יורק טיימס, אולי הוא לא יהיה מודפס על נייר ויכול להיות שאפילו הוא לא יהיה באותיות אלקטרוניות, אבל באיזושהי גרסה מסוימת שלו, המותג הזה עדיין יוכל לשמור על הערכים שלו.